I guess in this video, I'm going to discuss about how to connect DataGrip with Microsoft SQL Server Management Studio. So I have connected DataGrip to MS SQL. So from our JetBrains, you need to download and install DataGrip. So write in the Google and here you can find DataGrip, the cross-platform ID for database and SQL by JetBrains. So by clicking this here, there you can get the software. So like other software, next, after that you can install. So this software that I already installed, so I'm going to open DataGrip 2019. DataGrip, it's now opening. Now here after click on plus and here you can find data source. So right here you can find Microsoft SQL Server, click there. So add here the host name and here give a port and here after instance and here give username. This all those things. So add here localhost and here port 1433. Now here after instance. So let's open add here SSMS. Going to disconnect here, connect and copy this server name and paste add here. Now here after let's disable and here after user and password. So I'm going to log in with SA account. Click on connect, so it's a connected. Now here give SA or you can give any user. Now here after let's give password and here there is a bunch of different database are there. So let's give add here Adam database. And here after add here download, driver is missing. So we need to download the driver. Click on download button. So add here downloading 3 files. Now here after everything has been done. Now here you can see option. And here advanced is all the things. Now here after click on test. So again let's give the password. Click on OK. So and here preparing to connect. Now here there are no any error. Apply and click on OK. Now here you can see Microsoft SQL Server. Now here double click there. So it's connected with Adam database here. Here you can see add here Adam. So add here right click and here after if you want then here you can create the tables. So add here give the table name and here after click plus here it's now column it's added. After that execute here the table it's created. So the name is table underscore name. So this is the way we can configure DataGrip with Microsoft SQL Server Management Studio. So I hope guys this video is helpful for you. So now in this video it's over. So thanks for watching. See you next video. Thank you.